Alright, in this video we're going to take a quick look at a new flight camera which I received from Surveilzone yesterday. It is an 800 TV line Sony Effio-V wide dynamic range camera. Model number is CC1526. It is a 12 volt camera and comes stock with a 2.8mm lens. The camera itself I've already mounted on my airplane, but I'll show you everything else in the box. You get a little instruction sheet, kind of runs through the different settings which you can manipulate in the camera itself. I haven't even looked through these yet. I've only flown it once using the default settings. This cable is included in the box. Has a little connector to connect to the back of the camera for your 12 volts ground and video signal. Other ends terminated with a standard servo plug, ready to plug in and use with most FPV systems. There was also a sharp pigtail cable with a little small white connector and bare wires on the other end, which I used to mount it into my airplane. I'll show you that in a minute. This video cable here is included with most security cameras. Has a 12 volt barrel connector for power. It's just a standard barrel connector for your 12 volt power. This is a BNC video connector. I recommend picking up an adapter if you're going to buy a few of these cameras. It's good to use these included cables to test cameras on the bench. But this BNC connector won't mate with any of the other gear I have. So I have a small little adapter. You can pick those up for a few dollars. I'll show you that in a minute too. There was an extra lens included in the box here with my camera. I'm not sure what the story behind that is. They don't mention it on the website. I'll try to find out. It may just be an extra different lens that they included for the review. Because I should note that this camera was sent to me free of charge by Surveilzone to review it. They might have just thrown in an extra lens. I'm not sure. I'll try to find out. But the fact that I didn't pay for the camera won't change my opinion of it as far as whether it's a good camera or not. Just want to point that out. Here's your OSD control board. Has a little short cable there to connect it to the back of the camera. And you have your five little buttons, your up, down, left, right, and enter. Just like the 600 line Sony cameras we all use. And I believe that was it. It's just some other packing. The camera itself was in that there. Excuse me one moment while I sit my camera down. And this is the little adapter that I mentioned a minute ago for the BNC plug. It connects onto the BNC connector there. And the other end is just a standard composite RCA type connector for your analog video. Like I said, I recommend picking one of these up. They come in handy for using the included cables to test your cameras on your workbench. Keep one in my little flight box there. Alright, getting to the camera itself. As you can see, I have it mounted on my Skyhunter. It's just bolted to the top of my pan and tilt, my GoPro pan and tilt mount, which is a wooden pan and tilt from ReadyMade RC that I've been using quite a while now. I like it. I just bolt my camera straight to the back there, a couple of spacers as you can see. I had a 600 TV line Sony camera on here, but like I said, I recently, just this morning actually, I've swapped it out with this new camera here from that we're reviewing. It's a direct swap, bolts right in place, fits just the same. As you can see, I've removed the extra the edges around the PCB material around the edges of the camera there. I've removed those just to get a slightly smaller footprint from the camera itself, which I also do on the 600 line Sony cameras, but I removed them from this camera before mounting it. And on the back of the camera there, you can see it's a Sony FEO chipset. Your little 3-pin wire there for video ground and 12 volts.
This connector over on the other edge of the board here is for the OSD controls. It'll plug in there and allow you to manipulate the settings inside the camera. Not sure what this little 4-pin connector here is on the right edge of the board, but I guess it's just not used for our purposes. Could be to drive a different lens or something like that for security camera applications. But anyway, there's a camera mounted on my airplane, and I've already flown it. So let's cut to some of that footage now and check it out.
Hours 8, 1, 5.